friends, family, and faculty, and welcome to the graduation of the Cohasset High School Class of 2010. First off, let us all thank the teachers and parents who have been with us our entire lives, because without them, we would not be here today and this wouldn't be possible. So give it up for them, kids. You really can't compare anything to this group of graduates sitting here in front of me. You can't place them all in one group, and you can't really much to them because they're all so unique and special. We did things differently than others before us, and we've been doing that our entire lives, maturing into fine young adults in the process. It's amazing how far we've all grown as people, from Snapper Sneaker Day, to the fifth grade angry mom, to garage dances, to Camp Orndale, to middle school, to being harassed by Coach A, to now. It's been a long journey, but it most certainly has been an enriching one. One that will prepare us for all of the future endeavors the Cohasset High School Class of 2010 will engage in.
While these approaches do embrace our limitless possibilities in both college and beyond, they seem to overlook the past events that have brought us all here to this very place to begin with. The doors that we have already opened and the pages we have already written. To some, the future may be a chance to start fresh, but I like to think of it instead as a chance to bring a little piece of ourselves into an alternatively fresh environment.
I'm fortunate to have been with you for long enough to observe just how beautiful you all are. I've seen countless times what I believe to be the marrow of life. Our friends putting themselves out there, completely unaware of the outcome, just to give someone a moment of solace, the upper edge, an undeterrable strength. I've been taught by every one of you in far more prominent and poignant ways than any amount of student schoolwork could imprint upon me. And want to encourage you all never to stop learning and never to stop growing.
We'll go on to 4-year public or private schools. 5 will go on to 2-year or prep schools for a total of 98% furthering your education. Two others have decided to enter the military, workforce, or travel. How exciting for all of you, the next chapter of your life will be. Members of the class of 2010 will be attending some of the most prestigious colleges and universities in the country. You are coming of age during very difficult times. The country is demanding higher standards, greater accountability, and an off-the-head solution to problem solving from the Gulf Stream waters to Wall Street to the White House. So how can you be positive about the future during such difficult times? In looking back over the messages that I have shared with graduates over the years, I find the ones that have withstood the test of time through the years are the ones that present hope. Hope for the future, and that have a positive and motivational theme, regardless of the country's current state of affairs. They are personal, they are purposeful, and they are mindful. I'd like to share with you the graduates of 2010. Positive, and I hope somewhat motivational, top 6 list I did turn it from top 10. Of my favorite lines for you to hold on to. I hope one or two of them will resonate with you and empower you to make a difference and be positive and optimistic about your future. Number 6 on our list of lifelines comes from Chris Matthews in his Life as a Campaign. Never underestimate the factors of loyalty, friendship, investment, and reward in politics and in life. If you wish to construct a career, build it with what you know. Knowledge, talent, and effort are the building blocks. But personal relationships are what holds everything together. Change is inevitable. And you must change if you are to grow. Closing in on number 4 and 3 lifelines to take with you. Courage matters, and be brave. Number 2, for my fellow baseball fans, a message that is one of my favorites from Cal Ripken Jr. Get the game. Perseverance makes a difference. You can't win if you don't play in the game. One lifeline for you to hold on to in difficult times comes from so many moms, dads, grandparents throughout the years. No matter how far you go in your future, don't you ever forget where you came from. Your family, friends, and community will always be there for you, yes, even through difficult times.
Margot Elizabeth Donzie.